Well, good evening there, and welcome back to Kitchen Table Talk at Lolo's. This is yours truly, Lolo, and today in this episode, we have a very, very special guest, and I am truly excited to bring this young man on the show and to present him to you in the world to help many young men who are coming out of high school, who are deciding to get into college, who are deciding on a career choice, and take life further, take life by the horn, and take their life into their own hands, and take responsibility of their life moving forward. We have this evening none other than Mr. Christian Wilson, a Marine. Hoorah! Once a Marine, always a Marine. We're going to talk a little bit about his past, and how he became to make a decision to become a part of the U.S. Armed Forces, why he chose the Marines, and several other questions. But without further ado, let me introduce you to none other than Christian, a.k.a. Chris Wilson. Good evening, Chris. How are you?
I'm good, and you?
I'm doing great, man. Welcome to Kitchen Table Talk at Lolo's. We're glad to have you. Thank you so much for coming on. I hope and pray that our conversation would inspire many other young men and women, of course, and encourage some of the parents after listening to you to encourage their children to take on the role of a professional armed forces personnel. And because I've spoken to another gentleman, his name is Sergeant Chauncey Ayers. Right. He was Army, and he was telling me all about the awesome career choices that you have, that you can make. Spoke with a another special forces officer from the Air Force who actually received a commendation from President George Bush, the father, senior. During wartime, of course, his communications actually led to wrapping that up and ending the war, and his soldiers and his teammates and family coming back home safely. So we're going to talk a little bit about all these things, and hopefully Chris can help you young folks out there to make a decision instead of becoming just another average person to becoming a sergeant, a lieutenant, a captain, coming out of the armed forces after many, many years and being able to take very good care of themselves, retiring from that place in a position and having a worthy lifestyle at the end of their service. Chris, I want to ask you, so what encouraged you to join the Marines?
Not going to lie, it was kind of just a whim.
Say it again?
It was kind of just a whim. Like, I didn't have any idea of joining the military.
Yeah.
Like, no thought. You know, I did ROTC in high school, but that was that. I joined that because my older brother, Ian, he actually was in ROTC, and he wanted me to do ROTC with him as well. So, you know, I joined that. Actions, you know, led up to me actually joining the Marines because I had a staff sergeant that was – like an instructor in the ROTC program, and he actually told me about the Marines. And he's seen how I moved and how I drilled and marched and do all these type of things in the after school program. So he basically told me, like, this is not a challenge for me. So he told me to, like, look into joining the Marines because that is a challenge.
Okay.
Because it's the hardest branch.
Right.
Yeah. So basically I was working at Walmart, like right after high school. I was working at Walmart and I didn't really see myself going anywhere in Walmart.
Okay.
So I wanted change. I wanted to do something different. And it just so happened this one day a recruiter had came up to me. But, like, while I was working, I was stocking shelves, you know, and he just came up to me and he was like, let me offer you breakfast and we could talk about, like, we don't even have to join. I don't have to join or anything. He just said, I want to talk to you about the benefits and everything that comes with being a Marine.
Right.
And I kind of seen how his persona was, and
Yes.
I was like, this is nice. Like, he paid for my breakfast, and we talked about all the benefits of being a Marine,
Yes.
and like that kind of just inspired me to actually go through with it. And like I said, I didn't see my life going anywhere, but when I was working at Walmart, I kind of just took that chance, took that leap of faith. So yeah.
Okay, so ROTC.
Yep.
Tell me a little bit more about ROTC. Now you
Okay,
said
ROT.
you joined ROTC in school. You did it
Yes.
because your brother
Yes.
encouraged you to, and you saw him in his uniform and all that stuff, and it was kind of cool, I guess, right?
Yes.
And but your thing really was just starting life. Were you interested in college at all when you finished high school?
I was for like a semester, but
Right.
after that, I didn't see my eyes set on because I went in for computer engineering.
Okay.
So I didn't see myself doing computer engineering anymore. So I just kind of just fell out of it.
You fell out of love with college. There are many young men and women today saying that college is not for them,
Right.
that they don't see themselves going through college and whatnot. I know our daughter, she started to get burned out in school, and then she decided to she got over a hump, and then she fell in love with what she wanted to do, and began doing, like, she likes to get out there and she likes to be a servant. And so as a result of this, moving away from home helped her to focus, and she made it through. She got a master's and now she landed a great job.
Right.
For some young people, it's just not for them. So you decided to go and work at Walmart, and then after Walmart meeting this recruiter, you decide to go on ahead and join the Marines.
Yes.
Okay. Basic training. You do basic training in the Marines as well as in the Army or all the armed forces. Is that across the board? Do you know? I know you've only been a part of the Marines, but is that across the board for all of the armed services? A 13-week drill?
No. We have the longest, drill.
Okay,
The boot camp.
and how long was yours? How long was your drill?
It's 13 weeks.
13 weeks is the longest.
Yes.
Okay.
A
Did
boot camp.
you do a specialized? Did you study anything specific in the Marines?
Well, everybody basically goes through the same boot camp.
Okay.
So after boot camp, that's when you get put in this course called BWT, is
Okay.
basic warrior training. So
Gotcha.
everybody does boot camp and basic warrior training.
Okay.
Then after that, it's a third course that's basically revolved around whatever your MOS is. And that varies between different MOSs. So mine was a 1345, which is a heavy equipment operator. So basically, my third course was, I think it was 3 months. It was about 3 months. So yeah. So everybody goes through basic boot camp, then BWT, and then whatever their MOS is. And the boot camp is 13 weeks. Basic warrior training is three weeks, about a month. It varies, about a month. And then after that, we go to basically our job training,
Gotcha.
which is about 3 months.
Awesome. So Okay, so becoming a so ROTC and becoming a part of the armed forces was not really a childhood dream of yours.
Right.
It's something you kind of fell in line with or in love with along the way.
Yes.
Okay, fair enough, fair enough. And you did the 3 months plus the you did I mean you sorry you did the 13 weeks and you also did the 3 months. Okay,
Yes.
so that covers your training. Now, while in training, have you ever thought about you ever thought that you would have been deployed? Number one, and I remember. And number two, were you ever expecting to be deployed? Were you ever thought that you might be? And were you at a point where you were expecting to be?
Yes and yes.
Wow.
Okay, so at the in the time that I joined, it was 20 or 2020, and it was the ending of 2020, and I went to boot camp to 2021. Then that whole year I went through training and everything. As soon as I got out, they were saying that we were going to get deployed to China, I think. But it was like a I'm not sure what it's called. It was like a battalion thing. So it my the place that I was going to, because I'm also in a reserve,
Okay.
so it was a certain battalion that got picked to basically deploy. So
Ah.
my battalion wasn't the one that got deployed, so I stayed.
Gotcha. Wow.
So I was expecting to get deployed, and then I was about to, but they said, no, you just go to my unit, which
Gotcha.
is Bessemer. So
Gotcha. Now, I got another question for you. Do you remember what your family said and their reactions first when you decided to join the Marines? Well, let's go back. What did they say when you joined ROTC? Did they predict that you were going to be in the armed forces?
no, well, my dad, he always told me to join because it teaches you discipline and everything. But
Correct.
me young, I'm not trying to hear that,
Right.
So so I was just, like knocking it off, like putting it to the side and like just not caring about it at all. But
Right, right,
once
right,
I
right.
seen that my older brother had took initiative and actually joined, and he was, like considered high ranking in the ROTC,
Ah.
so I kind of wanted to be on that level.
Okay.
So that's why I did that.
Inspired
And
by your brother and his
yeah,
accomplishment.
as far as my dad wanting me to, do it, he still talks about it today. Like he wants me to go like full time active, but I just can't.
Okay. So, if you had to do it all over again, the armed forces. Would you do ROTC and Marines again? If you had to do it all over again.
Yes. I will actually go active.
Okay.
But it's only because, I had made a choice to do reserves so that I could come back home.
Okay.
So I won't be in the military all the time. Like I
Ah.
still wanted my freedom. But
Right.
if I had to make a choice to go back, I will most definitely go active, like full time, because it's a different lifestyle that active duty Marines like have than
Yes.
reserve. Because reserve, it's a lot more hectic. Like it's a lot more things that you have to like manage. You gotta call off work and go to the unit like once a month for a weekend. So
Right.
it's a lot of things that I would have went back and changed, but just living life. You just gotta jump into things and expect the best.
Right. I feel you. Okay, now you are now presently, You are presently an OTR CDL 18-wheeler operator.
Yes.
I want to put it like that. You're not a truck driver. When you come home, you drive trucks. Ian drives the truck. You drive a tractor.
Yes.
You got a CDL. Yes. You have to study combination vehicles. You had to do a CBT training course, take it online, pass it in order to get just to get your permit to drive. Before you had to go and learn and study the 121-point inspection for your rig and the inspections for your truck, for your trailer.
Right.
You had to go into, now, did you get your CDL in during the Armed Forces training, or did you get your CDL after you left the Armed Forces and start a new path or new career?
I got it after.
After.
Yes, it was after. So with that, I could have got it, but my MOS does not line up so that I can be eligible to, you know, get my CDL on civilian side.
Okay.
So the only MOS that you could do that with is the motor T operators. Like if you drive combination vehicles in the military.
Okay.
So since I'm a heavy equipment operator, I drive like bulldozers, forklifts, graders and stuff like that. So none of that is like combination vehicles. So it wasn't eligible to transfer over to civilian side for the CEO.
Gotcha. Now how long did your training take to get your CDL?
For the CDL, it was about 3 months.
Right around there. And once you, after you got your CDL, you had to ride out with a trainer. Is that right?
Yes.
How long were you on the truck with your trainer? Because I remember when I was OTR and I was training, it was more or less a minimum of 6 weeks.
Right.
And there are just some things that you just got to learn, especially backing a combination vehicle.
Yes.
And bumping the dock properly. That's the weakness. And it's also said that the most accidents that happens with big rigs, and I say big rigs, not tractor, big rig meaning tractor and trailer, 18 right. wheels, combination. If you want your back tail to go to the right, you got to turn your wheel to the left. Mm-hmm. You want your back to go to the left, you have to turn your wheel to the right.
Right.
And you have to use six different mirrors. Two mirrors on the hood pointing down to the stair wheels. Mm-hmm. You have to use two mirrors that go all the way back, and then you use two after the jackknife. You need that second oval mirror, a globe mirror, to show what the long mirror is missing in order for you to see where your tail is going.
Right.
Was that a challenge for you when you were learning to get your when you were learning how to back and bump the dock?
Okay, so when I was learning, it was very hard because I had a whole lot of people telling me different ways to do it. See, how I learn is on my own. Like I kind of see what I see. But if I had to have everybody telling me, you know, to look at certain things that I don't see, I can't learn.
Right.
So it wasn't until I got done with, like, when I was with my trainer, you know, I'm in the military, so I had to go to drill like every month. So it would prolong me being with my trainer.
Uh-huh.
So I was with my trainer for about 4 months until they let me go. Yeah. So
4 months in training, 4 months in training because of your number one, because of the armed forces. I got you.
Yes. Yes. Okay. So after that got done, it wasn't until I got in my own truck when I learned actually how to back up. You know, I learned enough to pass to get my CDLs and to graduate from Road Master Driving School. So I passed enough. No, I learned it enough to pass that, but I still didn't really grasp it.
Gotcha.
And working with Dollar General, not a Dollar General contract, going through those small parking lots and everybody going around you is crazy. That's really where I learned like how to back up. Like when I grasped the concept of backing up, because you gotta watch out for cars and people walking around the truck and all type of hazards, So it wasn't until after all of that, and I got in my own truck and backing up to docks, like I'm kind of seeing like what I see in my mirrors. And I mastered it. It's still learning, but I got it. I got it.
You got it.
I can back up anywhere now.
You're a professional.
Yes.
So you are OTR right now.
Yes.
And your trucking job. How many states have you hit so far? Or should I should start ask, I should ask you, how many states have you not been to so far?
I done been through about every state.
You already hit probably on 48.
Yes.
Okay.
Ex
That's pretty
except.
easy to do when you're OTR, when you're over the road.
Yeah. I done
And you're planning on,
traveled
huh?
from
Go ahead.
Jersey. I said, I done traveled from Jersey all the way to California, from like Detroit to Florida. Like, I done been everywhere. Driving through all type of conditions, like traffic, man.
Traffic, snow, rain.
Yes. Thunderstorms, everything.
I want to say this on this, I'm going to say this on the show. I'm proud of you.
Thank
I'm
you.
proud of you because I remember when you were in primary school.
Right.
Can you imagine?
It's crazy. Like, it's
It's
crazy to think about that.
you are a
You know
man
me all
now.
my life.
Yeah.
There.
And you've always been a go-getter. You've always gone after the challenging and you've always asked a lot of questions. And I believe that's helped you to get where you are now. I can say this one thing. Whatever you do, keep on doing what you're doing. Because you are making it happen, are accomplishing the things that you're setting out to accomplish. My question for you now is, where do you see yourself in the next 5 to 10 years?
Ooh, I was
In
waiting on
both.
this.
Where do you see yourself the next 5 to 10 years?
The next 5 to 10 years, I see myself owning an event space.
Okay.
That's what I had my mind wrapped around this past year. I set my goal for when I get out of the military. That's what I'm gonna be doing, owning event spaces.
Yeah, there are many, many events that be happening. They're meet and greets by politicians, their weddings, their birthdays, their anniversaries, their school graduations. You can do compartmentalized sections and have two or three different four events going on the same property.
Right.
That's what big hotels and convention centers do. They just pack them off and they just have one group here, one group then, and whatnot. But I'm definitely looking forward to see what the future brings. And not just what the future brings, but where you take us as far as your goals and dreams and aspirations are concerned. Again, I am very proud of you, Chris. Is there anything you want to say to young men, specifically young men, your age group, when it comes to sorting out their lives or making decisions on on the career path that they decided?
I would just tell them, take that leap of faith, because you never know. Yeah, like a blessing might be sitting right in front of you, and you would never look to, take that step in the right path. So I would just tell them to, keep your head up and always, at least look into doing different things with your life.
Right.
Because nobody grows up like knowing exactly what they want to do. Well, some people do, but majority don't know what they want to do with their life. And I just encourage everybody to, experience different things, like put yourself through different trainings and classes and seminars and stuff like that, just to see, like, because knowledge is power.
Knowledge is power. Get all the knowledge get all the knowledge that you believe you need, the knowledge you don't think you need to make the
Right.
best decision that you're not sure that you gonna make.
Right.
That's the path you took, and you're being successful.
Yes,
A
sir.
young man that's 22 years old, sitting in a big rig truck someplace in some part of this awesome country here,
Big Texas.
crazy. It's crazy. Now, you do use an electronic log, right?
Yes.
Okay. How's that going for you? Does that allow you to complete your miles?
Yes.
It does.
I don't like, going out of you drive for 11 hours a day. I don't like going over 11 hours.
Right.
So I don't do split clocks or none of that, 'cause it's
Okay.
confusing.
Right. Yeah,
So
you
I
can get
just stick to
confusing.
the simple 8 hours, 30 minute, get my 3 hours, drive the rest. Like, that's all I do. That's all
Gotcha.
I do.
Gotcha.
Drive 70 hours a week, man. I'll be rolling.
Be rolling.
I'll be rolling.
I can imagine. So the street life, the trucking life right now is something that you are getting used to and
Yes.
love doing.
Yes, I love this. It's my sanity. It's my peace.
What would you say to young men who want to drive big rig trucks for a living?
It's not for everybody.
Definitely
It's a
not.
mindset that you gotta have to, leave your family, take this big chance. It can also be good because you in a different city, like, every night, doing new things, seeing different sights. 'Cause I'm from Georgia, like,
Right.
I have no mountains around me besides a big rock, Stone Mountain. When I be going through like California and New Mexico and all these other states, like, it's just mountains everywhere. I'm like everywhere I go look like a picture. Like,
Now,
indescribable.
when I was in truck, I gave myself a hobby. I said, every state I visit, I'm going to collect something. So I decided on the shot glasses. I collect shot glasses. I have shot glasses from 48 states that I've visited.
Right.
What is your pet thing that you do? What is
Mine
your
is the magnets.
you collect the magnets for the refrigerator?
Yes.
Because I know some folks, they drive around their car, they would get a bumper sticker from every state. Yeah, because you can go to what they call it, town to town, the city hall, metropolitan office, where you can go there and you can get their stickers.
Right.
Well, you can make your own.
Yeah.
But yours is magnets.
Yes, I give them to my little sister, 'cause like
Okay.
when I first got out onto the road, I wasn't thinking about stopping at truck stops and getting something to say that I've been here. I was just getting filled and keep it pushing. But my little sister called me and she was like, "What state you in now?"
Yeah.
And she was like, "Give me a little magnet or something." I was like, "All right, I could do that." So all 48 states, she got 48 magnets on her mini fridge.
Wow. That's truly awesome. Man, well, I'm truly grateful that you came on the show and share your story with us. I would love to have you back anytime you want to talk with anything. I know you are. You're seeing some things out there when it comes to trucking. You're traveling the whole entire United States of America. as far as the armed forces, the Marines concerned, I won't get too much into that because, of course, it is it's federal, it's government, and it's the armed forces. You gotta keep things private. But with the trucking, for the trucking and stuff like that, you know, I would love for you to come back and cheer with your fans exactly how it has been for you. Another 3 weeks, 6 weeks, 3 months, 6 months, come on back and tell us how it's going for you, and give us some tips, some safety tips, some travel tips, some professional tips to keep you straight, safe on the job as far as street signs and obeying this stuff with trucking, because many people don't know. The four-wheelers, the people who drive regular cars don't know.
Right.
You cannot drive through or go under every bridge.
Right.
There's a 13-6.
Yep.
And if it's not 13-6, you might get away with 13-5. But you're not going to let 5 inches of air out of all of your tires to go under a bridge.
Yeah.
You're going to have to dial 911. And DOT or the sheriff would have to come out, or state police would have to come out, block traffic, let you turn around and be on your way without a ticket. But if you try to do it by yourself on your own, you could get a ticket if you messed up. And with this Qualcomm, this electronic system today, AI knows where your vehicle is at all time. It could be dead dark in the night. You try to bust a U-turn, they can find it a week, 2 weeks later, because when they pull the data from your Qualcomm or your Qualnet, they can see the electronic system and show that a rig turned around. You can get pulled into safety and you can get dinged for it. So when next time you come back on the show, I'd like for us to discuss a little more about the safety issues of driving a big rig truck and any other thing that you would like to discuss. Is that good?
Okay, that sounds great.
Man, I am. Let's see how long we've we've been on 28 minutes. I think we can wrap this up for 30 minutes. I'm truly grateful for you coming on the show and talking to us about a little bit about your life, and hopefully both of us be around to talk more about it in the very near future. Like I said, another 3-6 months, hope you come back on the show again. I'm definitely looking forward to that. Any last word to your fans, friends, family?
I love everybody. Hey, keep a smile on your face. Keep your head up.
Yeah.
Rest your nerves. No, cool your nerves. Rest your feet. You know, life is life, you know?
Right. Fantastic. Well, listen, man, I am truly grateful for you coming on the show. I want to thank you. Thank you very, very much for coming and sharing your life, really. I mean, you didn't have to do that. I'm grateful for that. And hopefully, is there somebody in this video you want to tag? Mommy, daddy, brother, sister?
Natasha Wilson, Alistair Wilson.
Yeah, you're going to tag them.
I love them. Right. I love them to death. They raised me. It raised me to be a nice gentleman, you know?
Yes.
Elijah, Ian, you know, Maya, now, everybody that I got in my circle.
Gotcha.
Quiz. Hill. With everybody that I got in my circle.
We're going to share the link to this show to all of those guys. And hopefully you'll be back on for another one soon.
Okay.
All right. Well, that's it for now. We're going to wrap up this segment. And I want to thank Kristen, a.k.a. Chris Wilson, for being on the show, Kitchen Table Talk, and sharing his life with us. And we look forward to speaking with him again in the future. For this segment of Kitchen Table Talk, my name is Lawrence Pintard, a.k.a. Lolo. If you want to join the conversation or keep the conversation started, text the word conversation to the number 470-382-9632. We look forward to hearing from you.